Adam County judge hearing arguments today in the Calhoun Square lawsuit, which claims the city of Savannah broke state law when leaders voted to remove the name Calhoun Square. WTOC's Flynn Snyder was the only TV reporter in the courtroom today and explains what happened.
A legal challenge to a historic move by the city of Savannah, supporters of John C. Calhoun's name being removed from this square, packing a Chatham County courtroom today. David Tootle is suing the city. His lawyers claim leaders broke a state law when they voted to remove former Vice President John C. Calhoun's name from the square, citing his defending of slavery. They say it reads in part, "No publicly owned monument erected, constructed, created, or maintained on the public property of the state or its agencies, which includes local governments like the city of Savannah, shall be relocated, removed, concealed, obscured, or altered in any fashion."
The city council, the mayor and aldermen of the city of Savannah directly and unmistakably contravening the state statute.
Lawyers for the city of Savannah pushed back, arguing the law does allow them to remove certain monuments in some cases. They say Calhoun Square signs are publicly accessible in the city's archives, which protects and preserves them.
Statute does not specifically deny a city's ability to name or rename property. Plaintiff's action is moot at this point because the property is now Taylor Square.
The square was dedicated as Taylor Square this year for teacher and nurse Susie King Taylor. The group at the forefront of that move has asked Chatham County Judge Timothy Walmsley to become a party in the matter, saying the lawsuit infringes on their First Amendment rights.
It was the petition that was adopted by the city to rename. We argue that that is protected by the First Amendment, the right to petition, and the right of free expression.
Judge Walmsley did not rule on the lawsuit today, saying he doesn't plan to do so for at least another 2 weeks to allow for both sides to file briefings in the matter.